Okay, play.
My name is Kent Osborne, and I'm the head writer on Adventure Time. My favorite character on the show is Ice King. I think because he lives alone, I live alone, and he has a penguin, and I have a cat. He started off as a villain, but now he's kind of lovable.
No one has ever said that to me before.
And I like LSP, too. She's really fun.
Oh my gosh, you guys.
My favorite character to write for on the show is Lumpy Space Princess, because she's super funny, and I like her voice. Penn Ward does her voice.
That was lame.
But it's so easy to write. You almost feel like you're cheating, because you're hearing Penn's voice in your head as you're writing dialogue. So you're like, oh, she would say this, she would say this.
I'm sorry, you're so stupid.
Yeah, and I love her. She's so obnoxious and selfish and, like, she's horrible, but you also like her. Yeah, she's great.
What kind of castle is this? It's like a poor people's castle.
Of all the episodes, the one that stands out, I think Simon and Marcy is, like, my favorite. I cry. If I start to think about it, I'll start crying.
I love you, Simon.
I love you.
I really like Bad Timing, which was an LSP story that Penn and I did. We boarded it together, and it's got some really funny moments in it, and it's got some great LSP soliloquy at the end, talking about love and how it makes you feel.
Through my tender love, you have metamorphed.
The idea came out because Penn came in one day and was all excited, and he said, I figured out time travel.
I have invented time travel.
He was so serious about it. And we were like, what do you mean, what?
It's not really time travel, though.
The process on how we sort of come up with an idea for Adventure Time is, it's pretty varied. Like, sometimes we'll come in and we'll say, you know, what did everybody do this weekend? And everyone will sit around and tell stories. And that's how you kind of come up with stories in the beginning. But then once the show's kind of rolling, it's very easy to come in and say, oh, we haven't checked in with Ice King in a while. Like, what's he doing? Where's he at? Like, where's he at with Betty? Where's he at with the crown? And so we're just like playing a game with all these characters and trying to figure out adventures. And then sometimes we play writer's games. If we're really desperate, we'll just sit around and do drawings, and you pass the drawing to the next person, and they have 2 minutes to write a story based on the drawing. And 99% of them you can't use because they're bad.
It's a first draft, don't hate.
But then once in a while you get a really good, someone will come like, whoa, that's actually a good story. And or even, I just like this drawing a lot. Let's figure out a story around this drawing.
Schmauzel!
Ooh, I think the best thing about working on Adventure Time specifically is getting to work with really talented artists and writers. All the storyboarders and the writers are super funny, and I've learned a lot just in drawing just from them. So that's the best part for me, I think, just being around artists.
We're kindred artistic souls.
Don't.
I think I find the most inspiration for writing for me is just things that have happened to me in my life, and constantly doing that, especially when you're boarding. I think when you're writing an outline, you're concerned about the structure of the story and making sure the beats are there and, okay, is this a story? Does it have a beginning, a middle, and an end? Is it clear? Is it making sense? Is it interesting? Is it funny? But I think once you get into then that you're sitting there boarding the story and you're writing all the jokes and you're writing the dialogue, you know, I'll think about things that are interesting to me or things that I spent a lot of time thinking about in my life. And I'll sort of use that to kind of pour into the dialogue and to what the characters are feeling and thinking and stuff like that.
That's where the stuff I can't handle goes. Kerplunk.
The best thing about being a writer is, I guess, free pencils. The best thing about being a writer, okay, is if you write something and then it ends up in an episode and, you watch that episode and you hear a joke you wrote and it gets a big laugh, that's pretty cool. Because you're like, I wrote that. That came, no one would be laughing right now if it weren't for me.
Yes, I did it. I really did it. I'm a true wizard.
Okay, my advice to someone wanting to get into writing.
Time to write.
I think the best thing to do is just to write all the time, like write every day, even if you're just keeping a journal of what time you woke up and what you had to eat and what you did that day. And just to get in the habit of just like always be writing. Yeah, just sort of like challenge yourself. You know, if you're waiting for the bus or something, like, and you see someone walking down the street, just write a story about them, like who they are, where they're going, you know, what their day's been like. One of the things I used to do, I would take episodes of shows that I liked, and then I would sort of like reverse write. I would go through and I would like try to identify, okay, that's a plot point, like that's a beat. And I would try to write out the show, like just to see how simple I could get it.
Whoa.
I think that's a good way to learn about structure, because that's really valuable.
That is what I'm talking about.